بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Also a welcome once again to our listeners, brothers and sisters on software online. أهلا وسهلا. تقبل الله منا ومنكم once again. اللهم سلمنا لرمضان وسلم رمضان لنا وسلم لنا متقبلا. We are now well past the halfway mark of Ramadan, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us in salama. Maintain the salama for us in afia until the end of Ramadan, that our actions are accepted by Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah grant us the favor of Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr, many years to come, and spare our life to be able to worship Allah and exert ourselves in ibadah in Ramadan for many more years to come, inshallah. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Tonight we recited from the 17th juz of the Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya, and then Surah Al-Hajj, taking us to the end of the 17th juz of Quran. Yesterday we ended off on a very important note, and that was the importance of Salah. As Allah says, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. In Surah Taha, Allah Azza wa Jal mentions and talks about the story of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his people in some detail and in different portions of the Quran. Inshallah, we will reserve one or two lessons specifically on the events of the life of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Many lessons to be learned from there, and some miraculous incidents that took place at the hands of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq of understanding. Allah says, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. Just want to highlight two things from Surah Taha. Allah says, from the soil did we create you, to the soil will we return you, and from the soil will we resurrect you once again. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ. We created you from the sand. We created you from clay. وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ. And we will return you to the same soil. وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. And from the same soil, once again, we will resurrect you and bring you forward in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This concept and this aqidah and belief, we need to entrench it into our souls, that this is a temporary abode, an abode that we have to leave once again and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a passing phase, a via point, the world of this dunya, batnul ard, very short lived, 60, 70 odd years. Some of us who may be fortunate, a little bit longer, subhanallah. This afternoon, Aruf Bhai's daddy passed away, his paternal grandmother, 104 years. But beyond this age, we don't hear, subhanallah. 80 years plus minus, most of the time, plus minus 80 years. But after that, khalas yani, subhanallah. And we need to return back to the soil. We need to return back to the soil. So we have to understand this concept that this is a temporary phase. This world is not is darul fana. It's a perishing world, a perishable phase, and it's not darul khulud. It's not a phase in the realm of eternity. Very short lived. We have to understand very well. Allah says to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Wama ja'alna li basharin min qablika al-khuld." We have not made for any man before you eternity. We have not made for any person before you eternity. You know, there's always a discussion and debate regarding Sayyidina Khidr alayhi salam, whether he's alive or not alive. The muhaddithin and the fuqaha have differed on this matter, subhanallah. So some say that he's alive still, others say he's not alive. And they substantiate using this ayat of Quran, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشْرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. Those who opt for the view that he's still not alive. But even him, whether he's alive or not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he's alive, then Allah will still take his death closer towards Qiyamah, subhanallah. Allah says, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشْرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. We have not made for anybody before you, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, eternity. It is the preferred view of the muhaddithin that Sayyidina Khidr alayhi salam has passed on. Allahu Akbar. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was that one hasti, that one being whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised up to the heavens. إِنَّا مُتَوَفِّيكَ وَرَافِعُكَ إِلَيَّ وَمُطَاهِرُكَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Allah says, we will raise you to the heavens. So just before they assassinated, or they thought they will assassinate him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam to the heavens, and he is going to come back prior to Qiyamah. One of the major signs of Qiyamah is the coming of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. But even when he comes, he will then rule according to the legislation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, the Sharia of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Subhanallah. So we need to understand this also, that when Isa alayhi salatu wasalam comes, he will be, his status as a Nabi will be there. His nubuwa is not snatched away. He's not revoked of that status. But his legislation will be now, his Sharia and his code of conduct will be the Sunnah and the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will implement the Quran and he will implement the Sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. And all of the Christians and the Nasara, those will be alive. They will follow Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, join the ranks of the Muslims and become one ummah thereafter, inshaAllah, bin illahi ta'ala. So we have to leave this dunya. How long can we live? How long? Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. Just after that Allah says. So Allah says, we have not made for any human before you eternity. أَفَإِمِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. If you die, will they live forever? These Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab and all these fellows, what do they think? That you're going to die and they're going to live forever? No, never ever, subhanAllah. أَفَإِمِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. No, that's not the case, subhanAllah. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every single soul will have to taste the goblet of death. Every single soul will have to taste from the drink and the goblet and the glass of death. Subhanallah. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And we will continuously test you with goodness and evil. Subhanallah. As part of the taqdeer and the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And you will be returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when we are returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says, وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة فلا تظلم نفس شيئا. And on the day of Qiyamah, we will place the scales, الموازين. Subhanallah. Imam al-Bukhari رحمه الله and المحدثين also coined the chapters on the scales of Qiyamah, موازين القيامة. Subhanallah. محدثين and the scholars make mention of different formats. One is a physical format where insan himself will be weighed. Subhanallah. Another one will be that your a'mal will come in the form of the books and the slates and the records in its physical form, put on the scales. Whichever way it is, Allah says, our actions will be weighed up on the day of Qiyamah. We need to make sure. فَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةِ الرَّاضِيَةِ. Whose mawazin have become heavy with goodness and hasanat, then will be goodness in Jannah for such a person. وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةِ. And the one whose scales are tipping, and the one whose scale is light without a'mal, subhanallah, that person is heading for destruction. So Allah says, وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Justice will take place through the scales. فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا. No soul will be oppressed the least, subhanallah. No soul will be oppressed by any measure whatsoever. وَإِنْ كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا. Even if it is something as small, as minute as the seed of a mustard seed, or even smaller than that, Allah says, "Atayna biha." We will bring it forward as a record of your good deeds, or as a record of your evils and your sins. Subhanallah. Allah says, "فَمَن يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ." The one who brings or who does one dharra. Subhanallah, you know, during the daytime, if you're sitting in a room and you look at the streak of light that comes, the sunlight that comes through the window, and in the streak of light, you will see particles of dust. Normally, you can't see it just like that. But when it is that one stream of light that comes through the window and through the reflection of the glass and that focused beam, then you can see those minute particles floating in the air. Subhanallah. You can't feel it breathing it. And we bring it in it all the time. You can feel it by tasting it, Subhanallah. Like the corona, the virus, subhanallah. How it's spreading through the air. It's unseen. Airborne, unseen. So, Mufassirin said, that is dharrah. That one particle of dust which cannot be seen by the naked eye, unless it is put through this high beam of sunlight that is coming through, and you can see that one particle of dust floating in the air. That is dharrah. Allah says, and there's one tafsir. Another tafsir of dharrah is the smallest of the smallest of the smallest particle that is in existence today. Subhanallah. If a person brings that worth of good a'mal, yarahu, he will see and reap the benefits of that. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. And the one who brings forward, likewise on the flip side, a small iota's worth of evil or sin, vice, crime, he will have to taste the repercussions of that. We make sure that we use these opportunities, like our salawat, five daily salah, our Ramadan, our Jumu'at, and all of these a'mal, to have our sins expiated from our books of deeds. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one Jum'ah to the next Jum'ah is kafara for all the sins in between, the minor sins. One salah to the next salah is kafara for all the minor sins in between. Subhanallah. So these actions and a'mal of our daily life, one after the other, they serve as kafara for the time that has passed. Kafara and expiation of all the minor sins of the time that has just passed before that. Subhanallah. So use this opportunity, these opportunities that Allah Ta'ala has given us for the expiation and the forgiveness and the wiping clean of our slates from all of the minor sins that have been accumulated in our book of deeds. Allahumma musta'an, may Allah Ta'ala protect us all, inshallah. Allahu Akbar. So, وَإِنْ كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا. Allah says, we will bring it forward and we will present it to mankind. Remember the ayat of Quran we shared with you the other day in 15 juz of Quran, that Allah says, اقرأ كتابك يلقاه منشورا نخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا. We will take out for him his book of deeds. He'll find it in front of him. Spread open. Go and brother, read your book of deeds. Read your account. And you give account for yourself. اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. الله أكبر. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Then we enter into Surah Al-Hajj. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts it off with a very serious note. Allah Ta'ala begins Surah Al-Hajj on a very, very serious note. Ya ayyuhan nasu ittaqu rabbakum. Oh, mankind. Allah doesn't say, oh, people of Iman only. Allah talks to every single human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to all of mankind. Ya ayyuhan nas, ittaqu rabbakum. Have the consciousness and the fear of your Lord. Be aware of your maker and your creator. Subhanallah. إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. The shaking of the hour is a very serious matter. The shaking of the hour is a very, very, very serious matter. Subhanallah. Today when there is one earthquake in the dunya, and what happens? Till today, every single year, all the time, the Christ Church is still recovering. It's almost 11 years now. Still recovering, still recovering, still recovering. The magnitude of Qiyamah, the earthquake of Qiyamah, subhanallah, will go way beyond the scales. They will not be able to record the degrees and the extent of the damage and the extent of the shaking of Al-Qiyamah. إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. Subhanallah. Today one building will fall, one building will crumble, a portion of a building will come down, some lives will be lost. Subhanallah. On that day, everything will be perished, everything will be destroyed. Subhanallah. Mankind will be destroyed. Everything will be destroyed. Allahu Akbar. Not very long ago, we saw the might of one earthquake which resulted in a tsunami, which resulted in such levels of devastation and destruction. Subhanallah. Those people who went and on the aid missions to the islands of Indonesia, large, huge barges and ships, container ships and huge, huge ships, those massive ones, up to seven kilometers have been washed inland. Subhanallah. One tsunami. Imagine, multiply that by a number that you cannot count. That will be the shaking of Qiyamah. Large, large barges that were washed inland up to 7 kilometers inland. Allahu Akbar. This was Qiyamah. Entire towns were flattened. There was no sign of a town. They just said, once upon a time, there was a city here. There was a town here. Talk to the people who went on aid missions. Subhanallah, they will tell you. Allahu Akbar. the aerial views. The UN will not release these photos, subhanallah, because you'll create panic. But the aerial views of the towns of Indonesia and all these places, Sri Lanka, many places got damaged. Huh? Entire towns were washed away. One earthquake that happened so far out in sea, and this resulted in the tsunami ripple effect that destroyed these entire towns, over 300,000 people. Subhanallah. In the zilzala as-sa'ah, the shaking of the hour is a severe matter, a very serious matter. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. Allah says, when the earth will be shaken, it's shaking. Allah emphasizes this here. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ. This is already a shaking. زِلْزَالَهَا. A shaking that cannot be measured. Subhanallah. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. Everything on the earth will be destroyed. Whatever is inside the earth will also come out. The gold and the silver of the earth, the granite and the marble of the earth, the minerals of the earth will be spewed out. أخرجت الأرض أثقالها. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the tafsir of this ayah, تلقي الأرض أفلاذ كبدها. The earth will spew out its kalaji, its livers, its internals. أمثال الأسطوانة من الذهب والفضة. Huge columns of silver, huge columns of gold, huge columns of granite, huge columns of marble, columns and columns of the minerals of the earth. تلقي الأرض أفلاذ كبدها. The earth will spew out its filda. Filda is a portion of flesh, and kabidha is liver. The depths of the bowels of the earth will be spewed out by the earth. What an earthquake must that be? Today, when an earthquake takes place, it swallows things. On that day, the earth will take place, it will shake, destroy everything on land. Whatever is inside the earth will be spewed out as well. أمثال الأسطوانتي من columns and columns of gold and silver, granite, marble, and all of these minerals of the earth. And the قاتل will come, the murderer will come, and he will look at all of this here. It's there for the taking. It's there for the taking. Today, we are digging. The lowest and the deepest mine in the world is in South Africa, Carltonville. So not very far from where we stay. Subhanallah. Plus minus 20 minutes. 20 minutes drive. More than 1 kilometer deep. Low, I don't even know that depth, but it's the deepest. So today we got to dig deep, deeper to extract one fragment of gold. One fragment of all of these minerals and these precious stones. On the day of Qiyamah, the earth will spew out all of these, and it's there for the taking. Take how much you want. All the gangsters come, all the gang members come, the ringleaders come, the killers and murderers come, those who broke family ties come, everybody will come. Sariq, qatil, qati', all of these murderers, rapers, all of these people will come, and it's there for the taking. Take how much you want. Say, fee, because of you I killed. Because of you, I broke my family ties. Because of you, I was put into prison. Because of you, my hand was chopped off. Because of you, I did this. Because of you, I did that. They look at it, فَيَدَعُونَهُ, and they will leave it. Because now, it's no benefit to them. Subhanallah. Allah. That is the shaking of the hour. وَأَخْرَجَتْ الْأَرْضَ أَثْقَالَ وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. Insan will say, what's going on? Allahu Akbar. Like today, we can't imagine this coronavirus. That we thought that, okay, things are subsiding now. And here, 350,000 people a day are being affected in India. Allahu Akbar. 350,000 a day. Those are recorded cases. Multiply that by another five at least. Or another double time at least of the unrecorded cases. Subhanallah. A day. We are worried. Inshallah, what's going on? When is this thing going to come to an end? And this is something which governments are trying to control and putting, you know, stimulus packages, etc. Day of Qiyamah, قَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. What's going on with the earth? Earthquake here, earthquake there, earthquake there. In the Americas, Pacific, Oceania, Asia, everywhere, Africa, all over the world. Earthquake. Media houses will be shut down. Because their towers will fall. Their buildings will fall. Their satellites will fall. How the information is going to spread then? Subhanallah. What's going on? Mala, what's going on to the earth?
يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا.
We have to talk about this, brothers. We have to make muraqa about this. We have to discuss this here, so the reality of our life and existence come to mind.
When we discuss this here, then it brings us back onto the path.
It curtails our desires. It reins in that horse, reins in that animal. You know, the nafs is like that animal that's on a leash. And the more you leave it, the more it goes. But the minute we discuss death, we go to the qabristan, the graveyard, we talk about qiyamah and all of these things, you start reining in the nafs. Bringing in the nafs. That's what we need to do.
Nabi Sassam said, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِي مِنْ لَذَّاتِ.
Excessively discuss the destroyer of passions. What is that? Al-Mawt, death. Excessively discuss it. Excessively discuss it.
Subhanallah. There should not be a single week that does not go by in our homes except that we have the discussion of death. That we are prepared mentally for death. When somebody is gone and somebody leaves the dunya, then we will be able to accept the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar.
In those homes which are void of the discussion of death, when death takes place in that home, it becomes like the entire dunya has come to an end. And the entire world is crumbled upon them because there's no discussion of death. So they are not prepared to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ.
On the day of Qiyamah, when this earthquake will take place, every breastfeeding mother will abandon the child one side. I don't care about this baby, and move on. She's running haywires looking for shelter for herself.
Okay, never mind this child.
وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا. The expecting mother will abort her fetus. She will miscarriage her fetus and she will start running for her life, looking for shelter all over the place.
Subhanallah.
وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارًا. And you will see mankind in an inebriated state, a drunken state. One person is running left, one person is running right, one person is running front, one person is running back. Dust all over the face, bleeding, hurt, broken leg. There's no direction. Should I go front? Should I go back? Should I go right? Should I go left? Which direction should I go? Can you help me? Can he help me? Nobody can help nobody. تَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى. You'll see mankind in a drunken state, an inebriated state. No control of our actions. Where are we going? What are we doing? We're just like, you know, in such a panic that you don't know where you're going, what you're doing, what you're saying.
Subhanallah.
You know, when an accident takes place, a severe accident, the one who's in an accident, he's in such a state of shock and panic that he's got no control of his action. He's saying things and he's doing things that he can't control. Imagine every single human being in this condition and worse than that. Sukara, drunken state. Allahu Akbar. وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى. But they are not in it, they are not drunk. They are not inebriated. وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so severe that they will not be able to bear this. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ. And also, my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a reality we need to remind ourselves continuously, every single week at least, so that our desires and our passions are culled. They are put, that fire of passion that is burning in our heart is continuously being doused and extinguished. So our nafs is all the time in check. Otherwise the nafs wants more and more and more and more and more and it never ends. أَلْهَاكُمْ التَّكَاثُرْ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَخَابِرِ.
يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا.
And then this day of Qiyamah, now you don't know what's going on, and here the earth starts to talk. What's the story of the earth? أَتَدْرُونَ مَا أَخْبَارَهَا. What's the story of the earth, Ya Rasulullah? He asked, do you know? No. The story of the earth is that it will come and give testimony. تَشْهَدُ عَلَى كُلِّ عَبْدٍ وَأَمَهُ. Give testimony against every male and female, every single human being. He did this on this day and this night and this time. This location, pinpoint GPS exactly. For this duration of time, she did this and that. Subhanallah. You know, they ask you, why do we after Salah, we move our spot and we read Sunnah on a different spot. And then the next two rakats of Sunnah on a different spot.
He said that because every sajda we make on the ground, that piece of earth will give shahada on our behalf. So let us increase the mawadi and the locations of shahada for ourselves. This will be the khabar of the earth, the story of the earth, the tale of the earth. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, fear your earth, fear Mother Earth, because she is recording. Today we got this beautiful new CCTV systems. Allah says, from the inception of the earth, Allah, this earth is recording every single movement, every single statement, every single action. Like they say, the walls have ears. The earth has ears. The earth has eyes. The earth has a recorder. And everything, every single thing is being recorded. When we make dua, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when a person makes tawbat and nasuha, a genuine and a serious tawbah, then Allah ta'ala will cause the angels to forgive it, forget it. And Allah will wipe the records from the earth as well. That is the kind of tawbah we ask Allah. That is the kind of tawbah we make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That every single record of that deed is gone and forgotten from the records of the angels and from the records of the earth and any other creation that is busy recording. Such a tawbah and such a forgiveness we are desirous from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq and ability of understanding. There's so much more to be said and so much more to discuss. Allah talks of Hajj as well in these few verses as well. Subhanallah. لَيَّنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا قُرْبَانِ. Allah says He does not want the meat or the flesh or the blood. Blood is going to go in the ground. The skin is going to go to the tannery and somebody will take benefit. The meat is going to go in the stomach and thereafter you'll excrete out. Subhanallah. لَيَّنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا. Allah is seeing on the occasion of Qurbani. What are you going to do? Are you going to sacrifice? Are you going to say that I will make some effort to be a part of this action of Udhiyya? Or you will say, no, it's too difficult in this country. Just pay some money and get it done. Or let this whole ibadah of Qurbani and Udhiyya be gone and forgotten from the generations to come. No, we'll be amongst those people who will uphold every single ahkam and every single sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us acceptance and tawfiq as we now come slowly, you know, inch towards the last 10 days of Ramadan. We are in the days of maghfirah. Ask Allah's forgiveness, ask Allah's emancipation from the fire of Jahannam and protection from these signs that we've just discussed here, the shaking of the hour. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a guide and Allah keeps us protected because of the connection that we have with the Quran and the deen that we are trying to uphold, inshallah. That everything should be talking and giving shahada on our behalf and not against us, inshallah. Taqabbal Allah minna wa minkum. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.